Hello everyone, Jobexi here. Welcome to Let's Play Prismata.
I don't consider myself terribly good at this game yet, but I am working hard. Yeah, so set of 8. Let's see what we have. Okay, we have an Isochronus. Okay. Thermite core. That could be valuable. I get 4 of those. Yes, that is valuable. Two drones. Let's see if my opponent recognizes how valuable that might be. I've never seen it before. It might not actually be good, though. Polywall. That I value. Perforator. Okay. Frost Brooder. Start your turn. Construct a Frostbite. Okay. Lucius Spinos. We know that's good. See a Thurnax. That is definitely good. Hannibal. Sure. Maybe that's good. We'll find out. I'm going to, go for a Blast Forge and a drone. This is a 60-turn game, so maybe my opponent isn't sufficiently familiar with the game to take longer turns, I don't know. Or to take shorter turns, I suppose, I don't know. That could be, maybe that's just his play style. You never can tell. Taking a fairly long turn, I should be investigating these further. Frost Brood, start your turn, construct a Frostbite, which to sacrifice it to chill down. I don't know how I feel about that. I can relatively quickly get these thermite cores. I can have as many pixies as I need. I'm going to get another wall. Another Blast Forge, I mean, and another drone. Okay. Now I can just start constructing pixies. Oh, wait, hold up. I pay attack to sacrifice a pixie? I see what that is. It is an attack bank. It allows you to bank attack and save it for later. Steel Splitter and a Conduit, and I think I can wait one more turn for a wall. Okay, I didn't realize I needed a Steel Splitter first. Now I can make another thermite core. Another steel splitter. And a drone. He doesn't have any attack base yet. If he's not careful though, I could just swing in with my 2 steel splitters and my pixie and take out 3 of his engineers. Okay, there are his steel splitters. Well, there might go another blast forge. Because now he can hit me for 2 and it really doesn't matter. Of course, it's going to start to matter. I'm actually going to need a polywall. How much till I can afford Tia Thurnax? Okay, so I can come in swinging with up to 5 at the moment. I mean, I could sacrifice a pixie to build a pixie. That seems useless. Polywall. Tier 3rd Axe is good, but it's probably a later game thing. Almost used up my entire turn. I'm gonna save. I'm just gonna keep going. Here's his Poliwhirl. Their Frost Brooder. I'm going to need an Animus. I'll pop in another Steel Splitter and a Wall. Man, I feel like I'm falling behind. I think I might wait for my opponent to blow all of his cools and then be in good shape. Because once his pixies are gone, he may be able to take out some of my walls. But the thermite cores are going to expire soon. There's another thermite core and a steel splitter, and I can afford a wall. Alright, so now I can pop out four thermite cores or four pixies a turn. Is that gonna be good? I probably lose this one already. I mean, I guess we'll see. I should be buying more drones. I should have been buying more drones. He could shut down my walls with his Frost Brooders. So I go for Tarzi A's next? Or perhaps Lucius Spinos? Animus. Drone. He has a lot more armor than I do. Dangerous. I can now do two Hannibal per turn, or one Hannibal, and then yeah, I can start doing Hannibals. I need at least six attack to make a difference, and even then, it's only going to attack a wall. I think I need to destroy the defenses. I could deal two of these, and then that only takes away two damage that I'd be taking. Oops. What am I doing? That should be a ball. That's dangerous though, because it's because all these frost brooders. And it blows all my pixies. Alright, I have to. So I will. Ooh, I didn't choose to. I thought that was an automatic thing. Can't save both. Now you can save both. If you get rid of all of your engineers, you can save both. I botched it. That was the turn where I lost the game. Oh, I needed another Animus. Do it. Nah, his walls are back. They're too big. It's just too much stuff coming in. No, I didn't ramp my drones hard and fast enough. Yeah, if I do get breached, this is just going to be a concession. I don't think it tells my opponent that I'm about to get breached. I think he has to figure that out on his own. Which means I might have a chance. Frostbites. Wow. Yeah, those would have been good. I should have focused on them as well as the Thermite course. That actually would have been a good choice. I completely missed out because I wasn't familiar with the, as familiar as I should have been with the Frostbite dudes. Do these have to be sacrificed? Yeah, they have to be sacrificed. But that's okay though, because there are so many of them. I should have focused first on the Thermite Core, then on the Frost Brooders. Actually, probably first on the Frost Brooders, then on the Steel Splitter, then on the Thermite Cores. Well, now I know for next time. I can get breached this turn. And I will be. Great. That's a concession. Very well played. Alright. Let's jump right back in. I feel like I have a little bit of a better feel about how the game works now. Alright, Steel Forge, Arc Impulse, Odin, I like Odin. Blood Pact, construct 4 Prompt Husks and construct a Tarzier with 1 for your opponent. I don't know how I feel about a Blood Pact. Antima Comet takes 2 turns because I start your turn game, but for each engineer you have it, sacrifice Antima Comet. I only get 1. How many engineers can I have? Like 20? Okay, I need one of those and 2 of those. I can have that. It's a nice bit of early pressure too. There's the Animus. Okay, so now is the turn that I need a Blast Forge. We are falling down again tonight. In this world, it's hard to get it right. Blast Forge. Trying to make your heart drone, drone, drone. But all it needs is love, love, love. Odin. Everybody, everybody wants to love. Everybody, everybody wants to be loved. Oh, 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 oh. Everybody, everybody wants to. Okay, so the Steel Forge can just construct steel splitters for stupid cheap. Whoa! Steel Forge, please. Darkness, I need a wall. Yowza. 3 more drones. Just let it in. Just let the love, love, love begin. Now I can just construct steel splitters like it's my job. I'm gonna need 2 more blast forges. Oof. It's gonna hurt. Okay, that doesn't sacrifice, right? No, okay. I need 2 more blast forges. I would like another wall. I'll come back with one of those later. I need a conduit. I'll get 2 more engineers. Okay, so he's ramping up the Tarzier pressure. Pretty heavily, actually. But I'm popping out steel splitters like it's my job. I'm actually popping out steel forges like it's my job as well. It's dangerous business I'm in. I need more walls. These walls are going to die. Unless I can put some significant pressure on my opponent. And more significant than I currently have. I'm going to need the Antima Comet next turn. And I'm just going to throw all my money into engineers in the meantime. He's ramping up the damage faster than I can. Taking 6 damage. Okay, 3 more steel splitters and just popping them out. It's just so much cheaper. I need to save a steel splitter because I need to buy an Antima Comet. Pop out the engineers. Am I gonna lose? Less fortunate than I, and let's face it, less fortunate.
fortunate than I. My tender heart tends to start to
No, I'm not buying engineers yet. I have another whole two turns. Exactly what they need. What am I buying then? Arc impulses. Even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face. Don't worry, I'm determined. This is very bad. I think all of that's actually going to walls next turn. Let's see. I really need more engineers to make this Anthem of Comet anything sort of worthwhile. Twelve damage. I need more walls. Don't attack. I have enough now. At the beginning of my turn, I'm just gonna need to come in with all dem engineers. I think I only get to keep two engineers. Now I get to keep more. Right, I need those there because otherwise, bad. Okay, this is dangerous business, but I think I may have it down. We're gonna make you pop, you burn. When I see depressing creatures, Anthem of Comet, I think this was the time for it. And soon enough, we'll come in with Odin. So much damage coming in this turn. I'm coming in with 16 next turn though, so it might pay out. To those just joining, welcome. This is Prismata and I'm Jobexi. He's coming in. Is he coming in with all he's got? No, he's saving up to block next turn. That's smart. He's gonna have to, otherwise he's gonna get overrun and his Tarziers are gonna die. Trouble is, the Anthem of Comet, it's a one-time thing. I'm gonna need to put on consistent pressure. I'm gonna wait for him to pop out the Blood Pact. Because I'm not. I don't think I can afford Odin quite yet. I will need more walls next turn. Just the age of 16 when I first went on the drive. After 6 months hard labor, at home I did arrive. That's rough. Coming in for 12. Girls, her caused me to roam. Now no, walls are more valuable than steel splitters. Alright, 13 damage coming in swinging this turn. Can't do that, need walls. Running out of drones, even. At this rate, I won't be able to afford much. Swing in for 14. Where she can sit and view me as I go passing by. Wow. She can sit and view me. That significantly reduced his ability to do damage, and now I do not need all of these engineers. So most of those will just become blockers. I would like to be able to afford Odin, but I can't this turn. So. Three more steel splitters and arc impulses. I'm gonna need more walls though. Are we out of walls? Not yet, we ain't. I am old and feeble, and in my
Problem. Big problem. I cannot apply pressure. Not nearly enough. Because this turn I get to kill one rhino. That's it. It's one of his new rhinos. But he's got all the Tarziers, so he's just got so much pressure on the board. I should have learned by now that Tarziers are just a really amazing way to apply consistent pressure. Because you can't be tempted to block with them. Other downside, you can't block with them. How long till Odin? I'm running out of walls, though, and that is very bad. I'm going to need to turn to force fields, and force fields are not good. Now he's moving into wall territory. Still got a wall. It's dangerous. Need a wall. We got a second wall. It's still bad. It's very bad. So bad. And now he's constructing engineers so he can use his anti-Makama, and I will not be able to keep up. I need pressure. I should have waited. And I can't even afford to go for Odin. Okay, so now I have a Tarzier. But it's not going to be enough. Nope, it's not going to be enough. I was too slow getting Odin on the field. I should have prioritized that. How much is coming in? 10? Okay, let's not do that. Just a second. These consume drones as well, yeah? That's why I have so few. I can almost afford an Odin. I'm out of walls. I need something to block. It's too late, though. I need an Animus. I'm gonna go with Auric Impulses and another drone. This isn't good. There's the two incoming. He's gonna probably use a kill one husk and then block the rest with a rhino. I'm taking so much damage next turn, it's absurd. I will be overrun. And this game will be over. Odin's just too late. Too little, too late. Oh, wait, I can move these? Whoa. Interesting. Who thought? Who would have thought? Yeah, because now I can come in with Odin. And it's completely useless. I scoop. It's
coming in at 27 damage. That was good.
Thank you so very much for watching this episode of Let's Play Prismata. If you like what you see, be sure to click the video on the left to be taken to my Prismata playlist, or you can click the video on the right to be taken to a random video in my channel. And of course, there's always the opportunity to click subscribe to be notified when I produce more excellent content. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will see you in the comments.